Good morning, everyone. I'd like to ask you all a question. What is the most valuable resource in the entire world? You could say it's gold, silver, perhaps diamonds, but nobody thinks about basic human needs as a resource, like water or food. The total population without access to clean water is 780 million, and the total population that dies each year from water-related diseases is 3.7 million. That's the population of the city of Los Angeles. Here at Gulliver Preparatory, we are committed to solving the problem of getting clean, drinkable water. To solve that problem, we built LITRES, the liquid treatment system. This is a water filtration system that takes water from any source and makes it clean and drinkable. This is the one we sent to Haiti. Now, after the disasters a few years ago, US aid associations already sent many water filtration systems over there. But they either weighed over 1,000 pounds or they had to run on electricity. Now, I can't imagine having to take a 1,000-pound system up a mountain to a village without electricity and just have it not work. That's why when we were designing LITRES, we wanted it to be light, portable, easy to use, and it didn't have to run on electricity. And it's immediate. You don't have to wait for a process to end. You can just get water right now. In 2012, Gulliver reaching out worldwide around the water system. And we sent the design over to the Conrad Spirit of Innovation Challenge. They awarded us with $10,000 worth of seed money to continue developing LITRES, giving it to more countries, more villages, and more people. Now I'd like to show you all a video demonstrating how the system works. It begins with a mechanical pump that takes the water from a given source and puts it through the system. Then it goes through four filters. The first two are sediment filters. They act at the macroscopic level, getting dirt and visible particles out of the water. The third acts at the microscopic level, getting out unseen particles. And the fourth and final filter is a silver nanoceram that gets rid of all bacteria and viruses contaminating the water. It can then be diverted into the tank that we have built into the system, or it can be redirected outward to fill other containers. Now, we have one system functioning in an orphanage in Haiti and another in a village in Nigeria. I'd like to introduce you to my colleague Sarah to tell you her personal experience with the Nigeria system.
I am very excited to share with you today about how I went to Nigeria, assembled the machine, and witnessed it working. Through my travels to Nigeria, I have been able to acquire feedback on how the machine works as well as what places it is used in. The first machine that we sent was placed in a local clinic called the Shigari Clinic, which is used for local women who are giving birth. One of the reasons this machine is so important is because children have to walk miles and miles every single day to collect water. This water is contaminated and was getting many people sick, as particularly the newborns, as Nigeria has a very high infant death rate. The mission these children are on is not even worth it because they have to skip school, so they lack the education that they deserve, and their family members are not even getting clean water. I want everybody to stop for a moment and to think, what would you think if you had to walk miles and miles every single day to collect water, and it's not even clean? It's a very tough situation, but luckily, with enough feedback and help from my community, my family, and my student body, we have been able to design and develop a machine that fits the needs of these people. The following video will show you how the machine works in Nigeria. Based on the feedback we have received from the end users, we have been able to fix and upgrade any problems the machine has had, as well as plans to send even more machines to developing countries. Now Louis will be explaining these matters. Thank you.
As Sarah described, countless people use this machine every single day in Nigeria. Imagine if we could have 10,000 of these machines worldwide. We at Gulliver plan to do this in three simple steps. First, we will improve the machine by making minor improvements and removing all proprietary parts from the system, making it easier to maintain and repair. Next, by itemizing all the parts, we will reach out to wholesale suppliers and other companies to reduce the total cost of the system. After helping the Gulliver business students help complete a business plan, we will then be able to easily visualize our goal of 10,000 units. Today, I'm very proud to tell you that we have five different systems in five countries around the world. These countries are Haiti, Argentina, Nigeria, Kasai, and the Philippines. These systems are all working, helping to get the locals access to clean, safe, drinkable water. In this video, you can see how Sarah in Nigeria identified a problem for us to use. She identified a problem of leakage in between the connections of the system that was easily fixed by placing an O-ring inside the connections. This was the simple solution to a very simple problem, and we found other simple solutions like clogging the intake, which was caused due to a misuse of the bilge pump. In this next video...
Flip back.
Okay. I don't know what happened.
Hold on, they're turning up.
Yeah, because I have two videos in a row, so... This next video shows the ease of shipping of the Litra system. It's very easy to ship, being able to be placed in a simple standard shipping container or a large suitcase with 2 years of spare parts. The system is very easy to use, 100% off the grid, and very easy to transport. It can be assembled by two people in under 10 minutes, requiring no tools for the assembly. The assembly of the Litra system is actually quite simple, requiring just a few simple steps. The first simple step is to take the filter tray and connect it. After connecting the tray, you place the filters inside the tray, and then you place the tray inside the cart. After the tray is in the cart, then you can connect the hoses at either ends of the tray, and then start pumping water throughout the entire Litra system. And now, I will transition to you, to my colleague Geronimo, who will talk about a new endeavor for Gulliver.
Nearly 11 million children under the age of 5 years old are dying around the world because of poor nutrition. Yes, this is Gulliver's new endeavor. We're not trying to fight hunger, we're trying to fight malnutrition. A lot of people might actually ask me, what is the difference between both? Well, it is very simple. Malnutrition is either the lack or the excess of intaking nutrients. And hungry is not having the food to eat. We first heard of the Moringa tree through a colleague and a collaborator of leaders called Dr. Franco. He not only collaborated with the leaders program to get it to Haiti, but he has also helped a lot of children in Haiti with malnutrition and hunger problems. He is very interested in collaborating with this project as well. As you can see, the many benefits of the Moringa are beneficial to nutrition and to many other problems. Here are gram per gram ratio of the Moringa compared to other foods existing right now. We're trying to build and develop a system that will eventually facilitate and enable the user to create a nutritional supplement. And this system needs to be three key points: portable, manual labored, and also needs to enable the user to take it wherever they need, as in Haiti, there's a lot of rough terrain. Now, this system needs to be able to produce a nutritional supplement that will last longer, because they need to be able to provide this nutritional supplement otherwise outside the community. And as well, needs to be portable and easy to ingest. Now, I want to ask all of you to embrace the questions after this presentation, and to help us revolutionize the world. So I ask all of you to grow together with us. Thank you for your time.